morning, children. Yesterday we have studied about the method of preparation of aldehydes and ketones. Today let us continue with the class by explaining the structure of carbonyl group. Listen here, this carbonyl group, carbon in carbonyl group undergoes sp2 hybridization. That means it's having three sp2 hybrid orbital which form three sigma bonds. Is it clear? Carbonyl group, the carbon in carbonyl group undergoes sp2 hybridization, so it is able to form three sigma bonds. The fourth valence electron in carbon remains in the p orbital. The fourth valence electron remains in the p orbital and it is able to form a pi bond along with the electron in oxygen atom, the electron which lies in the p orbital of oxygen atom. The fourth valence electron in carbon remains in p orbital. It overlaps along with the electron of oxygen in p orbital to form a pi bond. In addition to this, this oxygen will be having two non-bonding electron pairs. Is it clear? So here we can say that this carbon, at the carbon along with three other atoms will be lying in one plane and the pi bond will be lying above or below the plane. Is it clear? And here we can see that the bonds will be lying at an angle of 120 degree and they will be having a trigonal planar structure. Okay, now in addition to this, we know that there is a large electronegativity difference between carbon and oxygen. So this carbonyl group, a CO bond is polar in nature. Due to the large electronegativity difference between carbon and oxygen atom, the CO bond is polar in nature. So the carbonyl carbon undergoes, or it acts as an electrophile, as well as this carbonyl oxygen act as a nucleophile. Is it clear? The carbonyl carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization, so it forms three sigma bond with the neighboring atoms, and all these three bonds lie in one plane and this pi bond will be lying above below the plane. Is it clear? And there is an angle of 120 degree, as well as the structure is planar, triangular planar in nature. Due to the difference in electronegativity between carbon and oxygen atom, this bond is polar in nature. Okay, now let us study about the physical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Physical property. First, we can see that methanol, that is the first membrane aldehyde series, is a gas. Methanol, the common name is formaldehyde. And 40% aqueous solution of formaldehyde is termed as formalin. 40% aqueous solution of formaldehyde is called formalin, which is actually a biological, in order to preserve biological specimen, we are using formalin. And next member, if you consider ethanol, it is a volatile liquid. The other members of aldehydes as well as ketone exist as liquids or solids on the basis of their molecular mass. Okay, now if you consider the boiling point, we can see that the boiling point of aldehydes and ketones are higher than corresponding hydrocarbon due to the presence of dipole-dipole interaction. Due to the polar, the CO group is already polar in nature. So due to that, here we can see that even though it is weak, due to the presence of this dipole interaction, the boiling point of aldehydes and ketones are higher than that of corresponding hydrocarbon. But the boiling point of these compounds are lower than alcohols. The boiling point of these compounds are lower than alcohols, that is due to the absence of hydrogen bond. Okay, next property, let us consider solubility. Here we can see that lower members of aldehydes and ketones are able to form hydrogen bond with water. If you consider propanol, okay, that is, it is able to form hydrogen bond with water. So due to this ability to form hydrogen bond with water, we can say that lower members of aldehydes and ketones are soluble in water. But as the molecular mass increases, solubility decreases. Is it clear, children? That is about the general properties of aldehydes and ketones. The chemical properties we can study in next class. Thank you.